fly ball to center field.
That's gone.
Wow.
Toss it off in the end zone. Caught. Touchdown.
Smolar goes right side. Michaela gets it to fall.
Wide open. He throws it home.
You better make it there in that amount of time.
GCYAA football. Tonight, the junior varsity Cougars take on the Livonia Blue Jays. Hello and welcome. I'm Evan Chapman, joined by Ted Fournier. Ted, it's a beautiful day out here for football. It is cool. We're starting to get that wonderful fall weather, even though we're not quite to fall yet. I'm excited for tonight. How about you?
Well, it's a good day to play, too, and the Omni Edition Sports is going to bring you two today. We're going to start off with the 10 and 11-year-olds playing. This is their third, fourth, and fifth years of playing football. They started with flag football a few years back, so we're going to see a good quality game. We try to run, the Cougar program tries to run the same offense as the high school all the way through, so they teach the young men. So it should be a good program. The Blue Jays come over from Livonia. Most of these kids will be going to Emerson Junior High and Franklin High School. So that it's a rivalry right from the beginning, the Franklin-Garden City rivalry, which is always pretty intense.
The Garden City Cougar Junior Varsity Cheerleader Princess is...
We have a tie. Chase Provencal and Sarah Treso.
And of course, this is homecoming today for the GCYAA, and we're crowning a couple of young ladies from the cheerleading squad before this game.
Well, the young ladies that aren't facing you are the coaches. The young ladies that are facing you are the junior varsity cheerleaders, so all the ladies down there are pretty young, so. And the parents are lined up on the 50-yard line. I think we're going to remove them before the game starts, Evan. I didn't get the direction.
I would hope so. That's interesting trying to get across midfield that way.
Heck of a defensive line right there.
Or an O-line, depending on which side of the ball you're on. Yeah, of course.
You can see the sunshine. That's it. What you're looking at across here is the Livonia fans.
Of course, on the other side of the field, they do travel well. Not coming too far, just across Joy Road is Franklin, and it's where a lot of these young players from Livonia come from. And here come the Cougars. We've got a lot of young men coming out here from Garden City.
Well, you're listening in the background of Hall of Fame announcer and local comedian Kevin Kramus, and he's been doing this for 38 years, and he's got a heck of some stylings here, so that's what you're listening to. They're running out of the big helmet there. And running up in there. If you notice in their hands, I think they have a flower for Mom. I don't know, Dad doesn't get anything here.
Yeah, flowers are nice, though. Do the nice for your Mom. I'm sure driving you to practice every day or every day you have practice, you know. Mom carpool, Mom taxi cab.
The only problem with this ceremony when I was a kid, if I had to run from the end zone to the 50, I was pretty well winded, and I couldn't have played the rest of the game.
Well, these kids look like they're in real good shape, and if my brother is any indication, they got plenty of energy.
It looks like number 60, Lyndon Martin, coming out there. He's injured, but he's coming out there.
That broken ankle, broken leg, I didn't get exactly what it was, but that does not look fun. I've been in a cast before. It's not.
Well, the festivities, we have the kids coming out, but if you walk around the stands here, there's all kinds of cheerleaders going on. There's palm. People are got food to eat. They've got they're selling bling over there on the side over here.
Certainly, I had some from the concession stand and a little pepperoni roll. Very good. And of course, the other thing I'd like to point out is that every player has a poster up all around the field, and it's got to be nice for friends of those kids to make a poster for them.
See, next year I want to challenge our crew. They'd always accept a challenge. I want the graphics person to have all these listed as graphics, and as they come out, get them on and get a lower third on each one of these girls and guys that come out.
I would like to see that too.
I know our director could do it, but I'm not sure if our producer is up to it.
Of course, our director Christian Gibbon really does a wonderful job. Of course, our producer, Zach King.
Don't tell him that he's doing a wonderful job until late in the third quarter of the second game, or he'll be out of here.
Yeah, of course, we are going to be doing the varsity game after this one, but just about getting ready to roll here, kickoff for this JV game. Our national anthem, and now it's time for football.
Now we got to get the crowd up. Right, it's time for Jerry Odak and the weather. Here you go.
It's going to be 71 degrees, wind blowing southeast at 8 miles an hour. That's the far side of the field from our vantage point, back towards us. Should be very pleasant. I mean, it is pleasant out there weather-wise, but. Shouldn't really affect anything. High sun, not a whole lot of clouds, but it's a wonderful day for football, that's for sure.
And it's the small S, large S sunny.
Yeah. See, we're talking about the graphics guy earlier, can't get that right. All right.
Yep. Well, I heard he typed him in with a tennis racket, so that's his excuse.
That's tough.
Well, the Blue Jays from Livonia have got... What is that, six captains out there?
That's six captains, yeah. That's Garden City's going to have five. They got one less.
Now, remember, there's a lot of rules here. Everybody has to play at least 10 plays, five in each quarter. You usually see the first team against the first team. If when the score gets a little out of hand, 18 points, eight players have to go to the sin bin or the penalty box, or they just have to go walk down and they can't play. So... There's always sportsmanship involved here, mercy rules, and a lot of times you see the best players from the team that gets ahead off onto the field. So
it's nice to see these young men shaking hands. Sportsmanship is always one of those important things to teach kids growing up. I know I learned that lesson the hard way, and it took me a while. And again, if you're hard-headed like me, it's hard to get stuff through, right?
And we're glad that Evan, the parole officer, let him come up here and announce with us today. And we always look forward to that. And we have figured out that his tether on his ankle does not interfere with the audio this time. So.
No, we're not sure about the ref mics, though. We're not sure about the ref mics.
Well, we can't hear him now, so.
We'll get there. We'll get to the refs. I'm sure we'll hit our penalty at least one time. There.
And the highlight today is our executive producer, Hall of Fame producer, announcer, Mad About Town, Dan York, is on camera.
Well, if we can get a shot of him right now, he's on the phone, which is pretty amusing. But he's down there. He's holding the camera. I'm sure we'll get him on camera at least once today.
The Blue Jays have won the toss. They have deferred. They will kick. All right, guys, shake hands.
Well, there's the ref. Okay.
The Blue Jays won the toss, and even at this level, you win the toss, you defer.
Yeah, it's just one of those simple things in football. You know, everybody does. You always do it that way.
Well, that means we're going to see the Cougar offense, and you had an opportunity to talk to the head coach. And we're going to see Zach Russell at quarterback, and I guess the gentleman we're really going to look at is Robert Grant, and you know a little bit about these two.
Yeah, Zach Russell, he's thrown for two touchdowns, or he scored two touchdowns big time in their previous games. Robert Grant is only going to be playing one way this evening or this afternoon. He broke a bone in his hand trying to catch a ball. And he's a big-time playmaker. He's a slot receiver, safety, and he returns kicks for them. So we'll see if we get him on the kicks, and we'll also see his hand all wrapped up. Like I said, he broke a bone. So real tough kid getting out there and playing even through that. I know that I'm sure that that's not fun.
Well, is that number 10 and deep?
That's
there?
Him, number 10 right there.
He's standing inside the well, right? He's crossing the 30. But with you got a broken bone in the hand, that kind of limits you, and they probably don't want him to get hit. I looked in the roster here, and he's listed as a shortstop, SS. So.
Yeah, he plays shortstop, strong safety, receiver.
There's 16 on your file. We're going to have a little trouble finding these numbers because the rosters we have are in alphabetical order, and we have to find that's Braden Robinson we just had. There's look at the cast there. The ball goes.
There's the kick. Got a fall on it.
Yeah, they never got back to the deep receiver. Number. Oh, that is 10. 10. Got it.
Right. He's looks like he's coming off the field. They said he was only going to be playing one way. I'm not sure which way that is, but he's only going to be playing one way today. Like I said, with the.
Well, you probably want him on defense because you can play defense one hand, but to try to hold, squeeze that ball is a little tough.
Right. Right, he's got a big, big wrap, big blue wrap on his hand. Can't imagine that's fun. All right, here comes Zach Russell, the QB, and the rest of Garden City Cougar offense.
Now, Zach Russell has the defensive lineman's number 78, so. That's got to be the year his mom was born or dad was born because it's not the year he was born.
Oh, pitch. Stop for loss of about four. We'll call it three. It'll be second down here. Like we said earlier, gonna run like the coach told us, gonna run a lot of triple option, a lot of veer kind of plays, a lot of pitches, jet sweeps, rocket sweeps. So see a lot of that stuff. And that's similar to what the high school.
Well, they're calling it the triple option. It's a basic. You got two weak slot running backs, and the one's always in motion, and you try to run a lot of misdirection.
Shedding tackles here, out to about the 47.
Sydney Rad does on the tackle. Number seven, one of the Blue Jays.
That was Cole Quatlander with the run, broke a tackle. It'll be third down and six.
You're going to see a man in motion and some misdirection. Sometimes the first option is just give it to the fullback in between the tackles. Probably not a whole lot of passing out of this formation. Just a lot of just trying to get deception.
Mm-hmm. Looks like we've already seen some misdirection, some what have you, trickery.
And they're running out of the pistol here. Looks like number two is a quarterback, Cole Quatlander.
Yep. Interesting look from, he's going to hand it off. It's stuffed right there. Loss of probably about two.
Well, big number 77 is doing the happy dance over there. And we are 72, Cooper Johnson. It's going to be fourth down.
And that was Hazim on the rush. Lost a couple yards. And Hazim has been a big-time contributor for this team. This Garden City Cougar squad. And they're not going to punt. I don't know if we're going to see a whole lot of punting today.
Looks like number 10 came in that quarterback, came in there, Grant.
Yep, he's in there.
He's snuck in.
Yep, he's coming off now. Well, they're having a timeout here. Now, if we can zoom in, we might be able to see his hand and that big wrap he's got on it.
So far, 78-2 there, both in your pictures of quarterback. And to look that time, like 10 was coming into quarterback.
Those players are Russell.
Actually, I think Garden City might have been a player short. 3, 6, 9, 10. Yeah, they're a player short.
Well, that's a good reason to call a timeout. Up here comes number 54. That's Jaden Cook, offensive guard. He might have miscommunicated with the coaches, or the coach miscommunicated with him, whether he was supposed to be out there or not. You never know. I've been told recently that the sidelines of a football game, very chaotic places, very chaotic. So I'm sure it's likely that something goes wrong.
I think they're fourth down and long, and like you said, Mr. Ross Grant came in. Now they kicked the ball away. And the ball's
number eight there.
Trevor
Alexander, yeah.
Alexander went left, went right, went back left, and wound up out of bounds.
And he got it back to about the 45, maybe the 40. No, we'll call it 43. So it'll be first and 10 for Livonia Blue Jays now. Garden City unable to get a first down on their first possession. The interesting thing about this game too, especially playing, you know, all these kids are going to end up in Livonia Franklin, is, you know, these kids are going to see each other on the opposite side of the ball for a long time. You know, from here through high school. It's a handoff to Alexander, and he's stuffed. Ooh, big hit. Stopped for a loss of about four.
And that's our man. Mr. Grant.
Well, he's a strong safety, and I think he...
He closed real quick there. Yeah. I mean, he was stopping, then he came and finished it off.
I think part of the reason why he's out there is he's a speedster. Return a kick for a touchdown. You have to be pretty fast, outrun everybody. Once again, stuffed in the backfield. That's number nine, Derek Deedle. On the rush.
And the offensive line is just not blocking anybody. The Cougars are just... So it should be third down here, right?
It is third down. Okay. Third down in a pile.
It looked like the yard marker still had first down there.
And Bombaluski is the quarterback. Oh, right, there they jumped. Good hard count.
They'll get five back.
By Joshua, yeah. Still puts them at about third and 13 to go. Not a
encroachment on the defense. It's a five-yard penalty. Repeat third down.
All right, that's...
We don't have a white hat referee out there.
No,
they're all black hats today.
True. That's our head ref, though, in the center. Bob Allen, number two. Got to meet him, talk to him for a minute before the game. Very nice guy.
Well, there's another five. The man in motion came across, and then the right guard stepped back as he was going to pull. They were going to obviously
legal motion.
A sweep.
On the offense, five-yard penalty, repeat third down.
He's trading them.
Like the uniforms here, nice bright orange and blue numbers. I did a game years ago. It's white shirts and white numbers.
Yeah, how are you gonna do that? That's like
you just made up whoever carried the ball. And tackled. That's a third loss tackle in the backfield for a loss by the swarming Cougar defense.
And that was Alexander on the tackle, or on the carry.
Sean Salwa's back in there. He's the wide receiver for the Blue Jays. Livonia has four teams. They have the Blue Jays, they're mostly out of Franklin, and they have the Orioles that play mostly out of Churchill. Uh-huh. The Falcons come out of Stevenson, and they have another one called the Eagles, which is a little bit of that and a little bit of this.
Yeah.
So they have four teams to play, and the only reason I know that, my grandson plays for the Orioles, and he got his clock cleaned earlier today, 32-12 by the Livonia Eagles.
Wow. You know, I tell you, I grew up in Livonia, went to Churchill, but I went to Frost, too, which is a school that sends a few people to Churchill and sends most of the rest of them to Stevenson. And, you know, having four middle schools like they used to back when I was in school. Oh, looks like he's going to actually field that. Grant, unable to bring him down.
And they grabbed him by his broken hand and swung him around. He grabbed that ball right on the 50. They spun him around, and by the time they buried him at the 46, but he'll good field position for the Cougars right at midfield.
And that was a good shot to show you the big cast he has, or big wrap-up he has on his broken hand. It's like Garden City ball from just about midfield, just the Garden City side of midfield.
Well, we have to watch every play in here, who's the quarterback. And so we got number two, looks like he's going to be calling the signals here. And that's going to be Quatlander.
Yep, he's listed on our sheets as wide receiver, defensive back, and QB. So it looks like he does it all.
Almost in an I formation here, spread formation, something new here.
This will be interesting to see. Whoop, bad pitch. Able to fall on it, though.
He kind of didn't look at his back. He just took his left hand and shoved it out toward him. And it wasn't a good pitch. So, you know, back in the day when the colleges were all running that play, that was the worst part about the play, is how many times the ball hit the carpet.
Yeah, well, I believe it. That was Hazeem falling on that pitch, making sure that at least fell on it so they didn't turn it over.
John Davis is the big guy in the middle, starting every play at center for the Cougars.
We're going to have a whistle here to stop the play.
This can't be like Friday night.
Yeah, Friday night, there was a part of that game where there was a whistle on, or a flag thrown on about 15 plays in a row, I swear.
Oh, not easily.
It was... It was a slow game, at least for that part of it. Very slow. Every stoppage. Stop, stop, stop. Penalty.
False start on the offense. It's a 5-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Hey, you got it. Mr. Allen over there, the referee, doing a great job.
Oh, yeah.
And we're once again there, and they have four receivers out there, one back behind Quatlander.
Hands it off and immediately taken down. Once again, that's Hazeem.
Well, I don't know about if you notice this, Evan, but most of the yardage gained has been by the defense.
Yep. This might be one of those famed field position battles where, you know, you get a good special teams might be a big thing today. You know, get a punt and be able to return it for a few yards, you know, get yourself in position.
Same quarterback. This is three plays in a row.
Quatlander. It's interesting. Russell's the one that's listed as our QB on our sheet, so it's interesting.
Maybe he got banged up early because he was in one play and then immediately came out.
Could have been.
A pass, he throws it.
Oh, picked off. It's number two for the Blue Jays. Still not down, dancing his way, finally tackled at the 16-yard line.
Jack Deedle, he picked that up at the 40. So he gained 24 yards on the return, but that was tipped. And it was the old tip drill that they practice every night. And watch this here.
It's the replay thrown up.
It was tipped by the Cougar receiver, and Deedle comes racing.
We got a legal block in the back
nice
on the receiving
back.
Team. That's a 10-yard penalty.
Tackle.
It'll be first down.
And they're calling a block in the back, so they're going to bring it back all the way to the 40. So it'll be Blue Jays first down and 10 from the 40-yard line.
Well, you can't blame that on the quarterback because he hit his receivers in the hand. And he just tipped it up in the air. And so you gotta get that one to the receiver, not the quarterback.
Oh,
so.
Yeah. You know what John Madden says? If you hit you in the hands, you got to catch it. There's a backwards pass here. Number 6 for the Blue Jays, and there he goes. Mesta able to run in for the touchdown. Touchdown for the Blue Jays.
The wide receiver just takes 2 steps back, and he gets the ball. And now we got,
There's a flag on the play. It's all the way on that far side.
They're picking it up. The flag is laying on the 21-yard line.
That's Andre Bell, our sideline referee, throwing that flag.
Disregard the flag. Result of the play, touchdown.
All right. And here's a replay of him just burning it, beating everybody into the end zone. David.
Now that was, as you called it, Ed, that would have been a lateral because the pass was actually a backwards pass. The quarterback just steps, gets the ball, turns around, the receiver catches it, and he has one man to beat. Yeah. Yeah, this is the Captain Jack or the hook and the Captain. There's a couple names for this here. If it's how they
tackled, stopped. Yeah, that's a strange formation. Legal, well, but strange.
It's very legal. A lot of high schools run that. A lot of them call it the Captain Jack. Basically, what you're setting up different things. But if you kick the ball at this level, it's 2 points, and if you run it in, it's 1. Now the next time, they might run the same formation, and then it's a one-on-one right where they hike the ball. So basically, a lot of coaches say that you run that play because it forces your opposition to spend 15 minutes a day in practice defending it. So
figuring out what the deal is. Yeah, that is an interesting formation. I'm always interested in those kinds of things because every once in a while you see them brought up at the college or the NFL level, and you know there it seems like a strange thing to happen, but it works out for them sometimes.
Well, that was a big play. The big play here was a 40-yard touchdown after a penalty.
Yep, and once again that was David Mesta with the catch and run. And here we're gonna have a kickoff for the Blue Jays, and it is 6-0 Blue Jays over the Cougars.
Let's see if Grant's in there.
He is.
Grant is basically snuck up all the way towards the 40, but to the right side of his formation based on the last kick. And they
kick it onside, essentially. It did travel 10 yards before Garden City fell on it. And that was number 11 for Garden City.
Well, they don't want to get it Russell. So.
Tinsley, Dontez Tinsley. He's a defensive back and also their kicker. And that name sounds familiar, Tinsley. Did he play for maybe
City.
This is a younger brother.
There was a Tinsley Friday night on Friday Night Lights here. I see 78 chugging back in there, Zach Russell. So Russell's going to go back to quarterback for this series. John Davis breaks the huddle, gets over the ball.
He's got 1 back, 2 wide receivers, some motion. And it's a keeper for Russell, and he's able to shed a tackle, get about 4.5 yards.
Now see if they can run that and get that first option, either to the fullback or the quarterback between the tackles, then you make the defensive lineman stay home, and then that opens up your sweeps or your reverses. But the key is you got to be able to get in between the lines there.
Right.
So the ball's over the 45, 2nd and 5.
And I think I understand why they're subbing different quarterbacks in. The quarterback's running all the way to the near sideline, getting the play, and then running back. Those kids have to be tired out running back and forth all that much.
Well, that's why you make them do laps.
Yeah, there you go. Do laps for doing something good, do laps for doing something bad. Well, handoff. tackled quickly, maybe a yard gain.
Is that Trevor?
That was number 25. That was Hazeem again on the carry.
David Mesta, number 6 on the stop for the Blue Jays. There's a real good shot of the Cougar huddle. It's something we didn't see Friday night. I don't think either team huddled all night.
No, they were playing very, very quick football.
Now we have two wide receivers out here.
Uh-huh. A little motion, a little trickery, hand it off. Almost tackled in the backfield, able to get upfield and past the first down marker, down to about the 34. That was number 2, Quatlander.
Quatlander needed 4, got 9, so that's a nice gain.
It's a little more than double, eh? I can do a little math, Ted. I can do a little math.
Well, they taught you, was it, you went to Churchill, you said?
Livonia Churchill, yes.
Ah, good math teachers over there.
They certainly are.
So it's 1st and 10, balls at the 35. Garden City trying to answer. They trail 6-0. This wide receiver over here is 15 yards outside of the defender.
This will be a long throw. Nobody's near him, though. Oh, that one's to Quatlander, able to get a few yards on the reception.
Literally, if he can roll out and hit the wide receiver, was that 21 that was split out?
Yeah. Poirier?
Poirier was wide open that whole play. Nobody, yeah, Ethan. Ethan was wide open. Nobody was covering him. And if you can roll out that way, he's going to get behind his defender because the defender is looking at the slot.
Yeah, not very close to wide receiver on
the
outside. I think
Mr. Davis forgot the snap count.
There's the end of the quarter. Garden City up, or Garden City down. 6 points to Livonia.
That was a quick quarter, a lot of running plays, but like you said, they're down 6-0 on that pass play, but right now they are moving, and we're going to take a little time out here and talk about it. Corporate graphics.
Uh-huh.
You see the crews around here all wearing some fancy shirts here, and they get them at Incorporate, and what we really want you to do is show your loyalty, especially you old-timers. Get down there. If you went to West, we know that West was best. So, and I have to say this because it's my anniversary and my wife's a West graduate. So get down there, and now Evan's wearing,
that's Jason.
Can he model that? Can he do a little bit? Show us the back there now and give us a spin. No, I guess he doesn't have the Vanna White instincts. But he's there. And you can look that good. If you go to Incorporate, you can look that good.
Jason Merrill, of course, one of our wonderful volunteers here at Garden City. And he does a lot of stuff for us and, of course, wears the jersey very well. We're touching the camera. You know, I set that camera up. I put it in about 2 different spots before we finally decided that we liked it there. But it's a nice little piece of technology we have here at GCTV.
Garden City, 2nd and 6. And I heard a gasp, but that usually means the ball hit the ground.
Looks like it saw the referee throw a beanbag. Once again, that was Andre Bell throwing that beanbag out there. Looks like Garden City got the ball back, though. It'll be 3rd down, just about 6, maybe a little bit more, 6.5. This has been probably the best drive for Garden City so far. Got a 1st down.
Well, Zach Russell still in there at quarterback, big number 78. And let's see what he's got up his sleeve here. They're going to spread him out. Once again, I think these wide receivers, they're split, they're way out. If he can roll out and hit them as they get behind.
Tackle, oh, no. Russell still got the ball. Good play fake, and that's a touchdown. Cougars! Russell fakes the handoff, keeps it himself, and runs it in for 6.
So we have a tie game, 34-yard jaunt by Russell. Great ball handling there. And you see him, and let's see if they go for 1 or 2 here. play. You see a little counter. He put the ball in the gut and just kept it himself. And once he broke across the line, he was in free.
Now, good run by Russell. Looks like we're going to get at least what looks like a kick. Who knows if they're actually going to kick, but looks like a kick. And the kicker for Garden City number 11, Tinsley.
Just a little short, but he got it in the air.
And not easy at this level to make that kick. It's heck, it's not easy at the high school level either to make kicks a lot of the time.
Best kicker I ever saw in high school came out of Plymouth High School, and he literally could kick it out of the end zone on kickoffs from the 40. So
that's impressive. That's almost
that was
NFL
about five
ability.
6 years ago. I think he would head it out to Notre Dame or someone.
Okay.
But I mean, he had a leg.
Yeah, that's it's funny too, because kickers oftentimes have to have that power, but they also have to have the accuracy. You can't
right.
just have one without the other. Got to be able to boot it deep and boot it deep accurately. So, all right, guys, we got a tie game. This is a good one so far. Just starting the second quarter. 6-6.
Well, Omni Edition Sports is happy to bring you this. They've been bringing you Garden City Sports for over 30 years, three decades. And they're led by a couple Hall of Famers now, Dan York and Kevin Kramus, doing the announcing.
Of course, and don't forget yourself there, Ted.
They wanted to put me in the Hall of Fame, but I'd have to buy a suit, and I didn't want to do that.
Oh, okay. Big hit ball on the ground.
I think the Cougars fell on that.
Looks like they did. Yep. Got it back. All right. Onside kick or kick.
Is that 18?
I did not see who fell on that. Here, we can catch it on the replay here. Little dribbler.
Well, it's hit by the hit made it, but number 10 on the hit jarred the ball loose.
It was either 18 or 16. I couldn't tell which.
I see a 16. I don't see an 18.
Well,
Braden Robertson, I think, is on the recovery.
Yep, there is no 18, so got to be 16. Okay. Russell still in there at QB. Stood up after he handed off to...
Well, somebody threw a lookout block in there. I mean, quarterback got the ball, and I think the offensive line just turned around and said, look out.
Look out.
Because he didn't have a chance to even turn around and hand it off. He just got hit.
That's tough. I think that we saw a little bit of that with our Lions today.
Big number 64 is in there, Jermaine Grubbs. Gums. I don't know, gums.
Looks like gums. Russell's still in there at QB.
Big pitch,
deep. And he's able to shed a few tacklers, get outside. That's Quatlander.
Quatlander gained 14 yards after he got hit. He was trapped back on the 40. He got all the way up to the 46 of the Blue Jays.
Yeah, I think he must have ran about 40 or 50 yards in total, running back across the field, then back, then forward. Oh, man.
That was a 10-yard loss, and he turned it into a 4-yard gain.
Yeah, they'll take it, I'm sure. Third down at about 7. For Garden City. They're running a single wide receiver, big set.
Logan Allgood was way split out. I don't know if they were going to get it to him.
Dead ball, false start on the offense. 5-yard penalty, repeat, third down.
I noticed the fans are getting more and more sophisticated. If you look in the stands now, you don't just bring your blanket anymore. You got to bring your tent.
Yeah, that's a good look out there. I'll say that on a nice sunny day like this. You know, you don't even have to put sunscreen on.
There's three of them out there.
Just sit under the tent. Russell, that's a fumble falling on by Garden City. It's number 2, Quatlander. Recover, and it'll be fourth down and 19.
Zach Russell ran into his own guard who was backed up, and he kind of just backpedaled, and all of a sudden he dropped the ball, and Quatlander saved the day. Look who's hiking the ball here. Number 10 with the bad hand is hiking the ball.
Well, from what I heard, he's a playmaker, so I'm sure he can do all kinds of things. Well, it looks like it's his left hand anyway. Good punt by Garden City. It'll be downed at about the 38. That's what, 20, maybe 27, 28 yards on the punt. It's a good solid punt at this level.
Grant hiked it, Russell kicked it.
Yeah, that's a good punt. So, all right, first and 10 for the Blue Jays. Somebody looking to take the lead in this tie ball game. And it's been defense, all defense, couple big plays, and that's been about it for offense today.
And there's the look of a mean cougar. Number 6 with the ball.
He looks like a big kid. I think he's about a head taller than everybody else.
You know, we don't have the sizes of these kids, but I'm sure he's pushing 80 pounds.
Gain 3 on the play. 2nd and 7 for the Blue Jays. Bombalewski under center. Mesta again gets the ball and looks like he's gonna go. There's a flag in the play. Oh, tackled at the 30. They catch up to him. That's Grant.
Grant grabbed him by the back of his shirt and wouldn't let him go.
I think we're going to be saying that name an awful lot today. We've already said it an awful lot. I think we're going to be saying a lot more. Here's Bob Allen.
Well, Mr. Allen isn't walking down, so you know it's all coming back.
Yeah.
Illegal shift on the offense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat the down.
Illegal shift. Okay. So we're going to.
I think Mesta there came out and split the backfield, and I don't think he was down for a count, and he just took off.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Number 65 coming off the field, hustling.
Looks like the Cougar coaching staff all got the brand new shirts down there.
Yeah, sharp. I like that gray. It's a sharp gray. Uh-huh. Mesta drilled in the backfield by Grant.
Grant's just a ball hog. I don't know if he has a position. They put him behind the line of scrimmage so they can't get to him, and he just runs to the ball.
Yeah, he looks like he's got real good vision out there, really able to see the field really well.
He wants to hit, and we can tell you where he lines up. I don't know if it's middle linebacker or safety, but
shortstop.
Well, he's in the safety position, but he closes quickly. He reads it and goes to the ball.
Yeah, he's definitely lined up at either a safety or middle linebacker, and here he is again making the tackle. Assisted that time by number 4, Zemecki, Dylan Zemecki. So that'll be 4th down and about 11 or 12.
You're right, I think we're just gonna have a broken play here and a broken play here to score here, because both of these defenses are pretty stalwart. You see the replay. Zemecki and Grant closing in on the ball carrier. There's a 5-yard penalty.
Well, yep, that's a hard count by Bombalewski.
Encroachment on the defense. 5-yard penalty, repeat, 4th down.
Right, so that takes it from 3rd, 4th and long to 4th and manageable. Well, motion. Handed the ball off. Just short. Got about 3 on the play. Once again, that was Mesta.
I don't know if I didn't go to the production meeting today for the crew. But if we have the camera capability, the next time our Garden City's on defense, isolate on number 10 and watch how he's dominating the game. He was in on that tackle, too. He's basically your deep safety, and he reads the play and goes to the ball. And I think he made all three or four tackles on that series there.
Well, if he made that tackle, he made at least three on that last possession. But it's Garden City ball, first and 10. And Russell, once again, back in at QB. Had a little bit of
based on his versatility, Evan, I would imagine that the Cougar offense is missing him on offense.
I'm sure they are. He is a big play guy. Doesn't look like we have a flag. Big run out of bounds. It was number 16. Robinson.
Watch Robinson here. Robinson, we go all the way back to the beginning of the game.
All right, well, I guess we're not going to get a replay, but.
Well, that's what you get when you hire some guy from that Specs Howard School of Graphic Replays.
You watch out. I went to Specs.
All right, well, now that explains a lot. I mean.
Russell hands it off to Quatlander up the middle. You look at about three.
But I was going to say Robinson. Robinson came along the line, gave a little shoulder dip, went back out, stiff-armed this guy, got around for the first down on there. It was a really good run.
And I want to also mention that number 48, Blackmore, was playing wide receiver on the outside, and he could have thrown a block in the back and gotten a flag thrown on him, but he let the guy go, and the running back was able to get around him and make that big play. So that was a smart football by him, not making a block in the back.
Russell's in the pistol here. He's got a back behind him.
Bad snap, going to throw, throws it up, intercepted by Deedle. And that's two picks for him today.
Dayton Hubbs, 44 on the tackle. I don't know who that was attended to, because he had one receiver short and one deep, and he threw it in between them.
Clearly trying to get to one of those two.
Now, this is a little smaller ball than regulation high school ball.
A little formation on the offense. That penalty is declined. The result of the play, first down, Blue Jays.
Yeah, offensive interference. But you can get your ball and throw a nice spiral with that little ball that they're using. But he kind of lofted that one up and tried to, you know, it was a rainmaker, you know?
Yeah. So Blue Jays scrimmage from the 24. It'll be first and 10 here. Almost to the 2 minute in this first half. Very quick, a lot of back and forth, a lot of defense. Little dive play out to the 24, so maybe a gain of one or two for the Blue Jays.
They haven't really run a lot between the tackles.
They haven't. It's been a lot of sweeps and pitches, off tackle kind of runs. Motion, handed off to number 9, Deedle, the big defensive star of the day for the Blue Jays with a couple of picks. Third down here. Timeout.
Timeout. Jays. Blue Jays.
All right, still tie game, 6-6. Blue Jays and the Cougars. And here's the Blue Jays' upcoming games. They're going to play the Falcons on September 27th. It's next weekend. And, at the Rockets, Farmington, October 3rd. Some interesting games. A lot of Livonia there. I suppose they play a lot of in-city rivals.
Stop!
Right, yeah. Yeah, so home or away doesn't really matter. They all play at Bentley High, right? What used to be Bentley. Yeah, what used to be Bentley High now is the Livonia Rec Center. Yeah. This is third down. Nine to go. Looks like Bombaluski's going to keep it. Lose about 5 yards back to the 20. So, yeah, timeout here by Garden City. Looking to get the ball back with good field position with a minute and 16 seconds to go. Garden City
timeout.
Should be the
Cougars.
Timeout. So they'll have two when they get the ball back here. Right. So fourth down, just about 13 to go. And I wonder if we're going to see a nice hard count by Bombaluski. It's worked already here a couple of times today. Get a 5 yards to make it a more manageable first down. Well, he's out there on that field, and I would like to point out it's on his left hand. Now, I don't know if the young man is a lefty or a righty, but I assume he's a righty because, you know, 90% of the population are righties, only 10% lefties. But if he is a righty, it is in his dominant hand, which is a good thing at least. You know, you can still carry that ball in the hand you prefer. No, they don't. So it's like he's, yeah, I've seen a couple hard counts, and then the coaches call timeout, huh?
Timeout! Blue Jays.
All right, yeah, so a couple of hard counts. Nobody jumped. Now I think they're going to send on the punting unit. Yeah. And I think the Garden City's coaches told the young men, hey, don't jump on the hard count. You know, just, you know, you just got to contain them. You know, you don't have to blitz and get them to lose yard. Just contain them, and we'll get the ball back. So... yeah, smart play by those young men on Garden City side. A punt. It's a good one. Grant not going to. Oh, he tries to pick it up, and then he just falls on it. Ooh, dangerous play, but he's able to come up with it. So Garden City has about 37 yards to get to the end zone and 58 seconds to do it. Two timeouts. And back to your point about coaching, I know it's one of those things. You're in a system, and you know you get really familiar with the coaches and the other players around you. I think that's a real benefit for Garden City that they have a program like that. And I think that there's something to be said for continuity throughout. I know that Garden City's high school coach, Scott Murray, he's been much more involved in the GCYAA of late, and I think that's a big thing, very important. Looks like Russell's going to keep it, get stood up just about a half-yard gain, maybe a yard.
Timeout, Cougars.
The Cougars call a timeout. Yeah, he couldn't quite catch that edge like he wanted to, but Garden City will stop the clock here with about 40 seconds left. Certainly, so one more timeout for Garden City. We'll see what they come up here. I think I wouldn't be surprised if I saw Grant on the field for this last possession. Little playmaker out there. So this banner was put up by our Omni Edition crew earlier this year, paid for by Dan York, put up just to support the Garden City Cougars upstairs, and I think we're probably some of the few people that end up all the way up on top of the press box running cameras and what have you, so I think we were the guys to do it, to put it up there. No, it certainly can. I've been up there when it's been windy. Able to catch the edge. 20, 15, 10, hit at the 5, and it's stumble into the end zone. Touchdown, Garden City. That was number 16, Brandon Robinson. Braden Robinson, excuse me. A big time play, big time spin move by Robinson, able to get into the end zone for 6. Garden City lined up in the kicking formation. Kicks it, gets it up, and it goes right to the Blue Jays returner there. So 12-0. All right, guys. So with about 25 seconds left, it'll be Blue Jays ball after the kickoff.
It doesn't mean anything.
Cougars 12, Blue Jays 6. Right. All right, Cougars coming back out of the field. Blue Jays ready for the kick. This has been a tight defensive game so far here in Garden City. That was a big play, big time rush by Robinson. And the interesting thing is we've gotten big plays from several Garden City players. Quatlander had a few big plays. Robinson just had that big play. We've seen big plays from Russell, big plays from Hazeem, big plays from Grant, who's been all over the field from the defensive side of the ball. We have a whistle here on the kick, penalty marker. We'll hear from Bob Allen. Very likely could have been offsides. Garden City to kick off now. Ball's on it. Should probably hit him in that situation. Just touch him. I'm not sure. I don't see any laundry on the field. So it'll be Garden City football, or excuse me, Blue Jay football with 21.3 seconds left. Based on their formation, their trips left with a single back. Looks like they're probably going to go for it, which 16 seconds of the clock winding, you might as well do something. All right, looks like a little screen to Deedle. Grant is chasing him down. Not going to get him, but pushes him outside, outbounds. So good play by Grant, able to track down the elusive Deedle. Or excuse me, that's Mesta, my bad. Mesta, not Deedle. Mesta able to get outside, and Grant able to track him.
Timeout! Here's a BJ's.
The throw out to Mesta. A couple of good blocks, and then he just too fast for Garden City. Everybody except Grant, who the ball hawk that he is, able to get him out of bounds. Not, didn't wrap him up, but pushed him out enough. Good fundamentals there by Grant, who I'm sure in the second half we'll be talking about even more. Yeah, short amount of time on the clock. This is probably just enough for one play. So got to make it, you know, if you have that play in the back of your playbook or in the front of your playbook, the one that you think can work every time, you know, you can't bring it out every time, but the one you think it works a lot of the time, when you bust it out, now's the time for that play. You know, whether it's, you know, I remember Michigan State had a couple of those, you know, plays where big plays over the past few years, Rocket or Little Giants or whatever, you know, now's the time for your own Little Giants. Yep, same formation now. Trips left. Mesta behind. So I would think it would be likely to see him get the ball. He's been a big-time playmaker. Oh, they're going to throw it over the middle and knocked down by Grant. I think he would have caught that if he didn't have the big mitt on the one hand. So 1.3 seconds left. So I'm not sure if the clock's going to run or not. I'm not certain of how it trips right, throw it out to Mesta. That's a backwards pass, I think. I guess it doesn't matter. The clock ran out anyway. All right, 12-6, Garden City Cougars over the Blue Jays on this beautiful Sunday afternoon in Garden City. That'll be the end of the half. We'll even see a little bit of the little bit of the big helmet in the end zone there poking in on our camera shot. All right. This is Omni Edition Television on GCTV.
Looks from today's biggest music videos.
After cleaning out our closet, we have a lot of clothes we don't wear anymore.
Like this old pile of t-shirts.
It's not garbage, it's actually a new rug.
And to make it, all you need to do is cut, tie, and glue.
Cut the t-shirt into strips.
Tie the strips into knots.
And glue the knots to the bath mat. I love it. Give your garbage another life.
And recycle.
Welcome back to Garden City High School. We've got a great game going here between the Garden City Cougar JV squad and the Livonia Blue Jays JV squad. And of course, I'm joined by Ted. Ted, it's been a really, really good first half. Really good defense so far.
A lot of good defenses and a couple big plays have scored. We haven't got any extra points, so it's 12-6 Garden City. But Garden City scored on really some good coaching and some big play. The Blue Jays were deep in their own zone and they punted. Garden City fell on the ball on the 39-yard line. And then Braden Robinson, he swept to the left and he got around the end. He stiff-armed one guy and then he was tiptoeing down the sidelines and he almost fell down. I mean, they hit him and he kept his balance. And then when he finally got contact, probably around the 5-yard line, he used that contact to spin off and go into the end zone. So it was a very athletic play to put the Cougars ahead. And now they're going to kick off, get the Blue Jays the ball back to start. But they've had some great defense led by number 10, Grant. Grant's been all over the field. It's almost like the top 10 people are keeping all the white shirts off of Grant, and Grant's going to make the tackles.
And he's been in on almost every tackle so far today, or been around it. He's been quite the performer today for Garden City. Garden City kicks off, number 23 for the Blue Jays, runs backwards, loses a couple yards from where he caught the ball. That's Caden Stout for the Blue Jays.
He'd have been better off just falling forward, and he would have been in Cougar territory, but he was looking for some grass to run on, and every time he turned around, he went backwards.
Right, so it'll be the Blue Jays first down here on the 46.
Now on the back of your screen there on the shot, you see big number 10. Well, you saw number 10. Keep your eyes on him, because basically what's happening, the Blue Jays are hiking the ball, and number 10 is making a beeline right to the ball and making the play.
He's certainly got a radar for the football all today. Let's see, watch him here, number 6. That's Mesta around the end. We got a couple flags out there, and Mesta's still going. 20, 15, 10, and into the end zone. I think this one's coming back though on a hold. We also have a Cougar down on the side of the field. Looks to be hurt. Here's a replay of Mesta. See, here's the big thing. Number 10 right there, Grant. Unable to make the play, trying to stay with Mesta, but there comes a flag, and you see that. And Mesta, little stutter stop, pushes Grant out of the way, the break, the tackle, and keep going down the sideline. Wow, good run in there by Mesta.
There's a flag laying at the 49-yard line, so if that's the point of the penalty, this ball's gonna come back. This is gonna be, in effect, there is an injured Cougar down.
Yeah, I haven't been able to get a good look at who it was.
Well, they're checking his leg, so that's.
Well, he's moving it around.
He's moving his other leg, so his head and everything is good.
He's sitting up, okay.
Once again, the 50-50 winning number 046.
Yes, what? Doesn't want to put a whole lot. Is that 72?
That's number 11. 11? I think that's 11, Tinsley. And that was that was one thing I spoke with the coaches about, these new jerseys. They're real sharp, but the letters are, or the numbers are a little tough to read sometimes. So I think that's Tinsley, and that's their kicker too. So
he doesn't want to put much weight on that.
No, he might have got rolled up on, rolled ankle, rolled something. That's
no
fun.
One of these dads to pick them up and carry them off.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, they're doing that'll help them out.
Yeah, he'll. Personal foul. All right, so now instead of first and 10, it's first and 20 for the Blue Jays.
Now I was gonna tell you, as that play started and the man went in motion for the Blue Jays, there were three Cougars still looking toward the sidelines like they're doing right now, looking for a play. And you see the Blue Jays are pretty well in their formation, but the Cougars were not set for that play defensively. And they were still looking to the sidelines for what they were supposed to do when the Blue Jays ran the play.
Clearly on the same page now. Here's Mesta with the ball. He'll be tackled. Loss of about one. So that makes it second and 21 for the Blue Jays.
And I'm sorry we keep mentioning Grant, but he was in on that play too.
I don't think you have to apologize. He's been
he's
been all over the field.
You see how quick the Blue Jays are getting set, and if they snap that ball, there's a blitz.
Yeah, they're handing the ball. This is the third time in a row they've handed the ball.
All right, close your eyes and tell me who from his safety spot blitzed and made a tackle for a loss.
I think it's probably Grant. Probably Grant, yeah.
Okay.
In fact, maybe this next play I'll close my eyes.
See how quick the Blue Jays are now going no huddle.
Little up tempo, try to get the offense going here. It's been a very, very tight defensive game, so maybe a little O is what the doctor ordered. A pass play to Mesta, and Grant comes from behind and tackles him. Big time play by Grant.
I'm not sure what you can do about that, but I'd find somebody put a helmet on number 10.
Yeah, somebody, maybe your best blocker, one of your better blockers, go and, you know, make sure you block him every time or as much as you can. Good tackle, and number 16 for Garden City got in on that as well.
Robinson,
the touchdown scorer, one that put the Garden City ahead.
They're going for it here on fourth down. There's no punter.
Fourth and a mile. Well, looks like I'm not sure if that was a false start or a encroachment. I couldn't tell you.
No, they're going to say it's a false start.
And a couple of the Blue Jays aren't real happy. I've seen them making motions at the refs. That's
Noah Posen was a little upset with that. Number 40. He was the deep. Now we got a whole new team coming in.
Yeah, it could be the punt unit.
We remind you that each player has to play five plays from scrimmage on each side. So a lot of times you'll see coaches making wholesale substitutions for one play, and then they actually have a coach on each side that keeps track of who's in and who's out. Red's gonna punt.
Sydney Red. High snap, can't handle it. Tackled for a big time loss. That's not good for the Blue Jays. Turns out good for Garden City. Garden City's gonna start with terrific field position, first and 10 from the 27.
That's a huge play, because watch the blitz come out from the outside in, and they, Garden City just came through on a little bad snap, and Red basically did a good job just catching the ball and falling on it. So it's looked at the 27-yard line, 26-yard line. Now Garden City, that's a huge play there.
That is a big time stop on fourth down. They were gonna get the ball back anyway because they were punting, but to get this kind of field position is big time. The keeper for the quarterback, that's Russell, he's able to scrounge out about 2 yards.
If Russell rolls out and throws it to his wide receiver who splits out, nobody's really covering that wide receiver out there.
Well, he's out there on an island all by himself.
Poirier was out there one time. I'm not sure. It's Poirier. He looks like he's on this side of the formation now, 21. Russell's heading back into the huddle.
And like I said, those kids, those quarterbacks, running back and forth, getting the plays, come back, come getting play, come back, running around like he has. Good thing up. Little plane. That's the plane Dan York will be flying down to Florida later.
See, Dayton Hobbs
caught on the outside. That's a first down, Garden City. 44. Yep, Hobbs.
Hobbs was the one to the far side, and that ball was arced out to him. Yeah. If it was a line drive, he would have been wide open.
Oh yeah. Now that name's familiar too. His older brother, I assume, played for Garden City, Hobbs. It could be a cousin or somebody, who knows? I'm sure they do, I'm sure they could tell us.
Garden City threatening here. Russell heaves another one, has another receiver, it's complete, this time to Poirier.
And like you said, he's wide open out there.
Well, they're not really going out and covering him one-to-one, they're letting him on the outside.
This is a good pass, look at the spiral on this thing. Real good spiral right to him. Good throw.
And you see the goal line there. That was a gain of 7, they said, and it's going to be 2nd and 3.
Garden City threatening. Hands the ball off to Hazeem, unable to get anything there.
There's a flag on the play. It Did we finally give Dan York a shot? Was that Dan's shot there on the play?
I've seen a few of Dan's shots.
Oh, where is he? I don't even know where he's. Where's he at?
Dan running the handheld camera on the sideline.
Oh, okay. That must have been Dan's shot. And mark that, because I think we could get him
a legal motion on the offense. Penalties declined.
Did you know the grass was in focus and the plague was in focus and everything?
Yeah, that's 30 years in the business for you.
He had the plague in both in the lower third and the middle third. It was well.
That was
conditioned
a nice shot.
Yes.
Well, nice shot. All right, Dan York. There's some Dan again.
That's a Dan shot. Stay with him. Stay with Dan. Oh, missed.
All right, well, not quite what they were looking for there for Garden City. It'll be fourth down and about 6 or 7 from the 11-yard line. So this is kind of that in between, not sure. I'm sure they're going to go for it because it would give Blue Jays a real tough field position.
Well, even if you hold them down here, then your defense has been doing a wonderful job. There's another, I just think we'll call it a Yorkie.
A Yorkie?
Well, you got your selfies, and now you have your Yorkies.
Your Yorkie. Yeah, okay, I can dig that. I'm just interested to hear what Dan has to say about that.
I'll probably be fired.
No, I'll probably leave before he hears. Around the end, Robinson. Very close to a first down. I don't think he got there, though. I think he's about a half yard short. Whew. Tough running there by the quarterback for Garden City.
It's right on the 5.
It's very close.
So it'll be first down for the Blue Jays. Now we'll see the replay here.
This is a Yorkie too.
He comes right at your camera there. Dan's getting out of the way so he doesn't get hit.
Yep, stopped him right there at the 5. They needed the 4.5. Very close.
Well, the ref made a good spot. You got to go. Now the defense here has to stand. And yeah, then they'll have a good field position again. They got to keep the Blue Jays down here.
And the guy they probably have to stop more than anybody is the guy that we've said his name a lot is David Mesta. He's been the one carrying the ball a lot for the Blue Jays.
Yeah, he's in the end zone. Does he get back out? Yeah, yeah. He does. And I think Garden City ran that play with started out with 9. I counted 10 when they ran somebody on the field. So I know they started out with not 11. So.
Well, I guess that's just a testament to defense. Even one man short, they can stop for a loss. That's pretty good. So now they're down to about the 1 yard line.
Well, they could get a safety here.
They could. They could. That'd make it look like they made both extra points. Oh, little movement. I think that's going to be down the offense. False start.
Number 22.
Dead ball. False start on the offense.
Cooper,
half the distance to the goal. Repeat the down.
Doing a little refereeing there for the Blue Jays.
He's pointing at the other team.
Yeah, they got half a yard on that penalty.
Yeah.
Quarterback's just got to go forward here. They need some space.
Yep, that's what they're doing, and it looks like he's going to be stood up right there at the 1.
Well, he got out of the end zone, so he's not going to be. They always give you your forward motion.
Naturally. So, third down now from about the 1 yard line.
I just counted. Garden City does have an 11 out there. But that first play, they were running somebody on when the play started. Same thing.
Yeah, you're going to have to push out, get some space. I don't know how you do it, though. I feel like here I would want to run a screen or something. I don't know. Or maybe hard count, get them to come off sides. I don't know.
Safety.
Motion. Oh, he might have gotten out of there. I'm not sure. Yeah, they're probably – looks like they're going to – Looks like they're going to mark him at
Grant me. Wanted to save. There's the man we've been talking about all day.
And there's that mitt you can see. Got two of his fingers stuck. That's a great shot. That's a great shot, Dan.
Timeout!
I'm telling you, award.
Blue Jays!
Well, they're going to have to kick it out of here. And even with a great kick, the farthest it's going to go out to is probably going to be the 29-30 in that area. So Garden City leading 12-6 here with a 1:29 left on the clock here in the third. Has a great chance with great field position. Hey, for two things, Evan, either score or just keep Blue Jays down there because they're 98 yards away from a touchdown.
True, and this is one of those games where we talked about it earlier. Field position is going to be a big-time factor. So even if you stall out, let's say you go three and out, and you punt it again or you go for it on fourth down and don't quite get it, you know, they're still only going to be at about the 20. They'll still have 80 yards.
There's all the dads and their daughters. We have a daddy-daughter dance here going.
Yeah, they're playing the chicken dance. I always, you want to do the chicken dance with me right now, Ted? I'll do it. As long as Jason or Dan isn't going to get us on camera doing the chicken dance.
Yeah, but you want to lead all the time.
True.
Yeah, the fans are into it. All right, Evan, so what are we going to do here? We're going to kick.
We got a
punter here.
This is what you hope. They had a bad snap last time, so you hope the snap is good.
That's red.
Yep. Well, that's a good, solid punt. Going to bounce out to about the 30-yard line. Looks like it's going to stop at the 29. Just like you said, you called it, Ted.
The lotto numbers tonight are... Well, that's a great defensive stand for the JV Cougars here, and now they have once again great field position. If they need two first downs, then they'll be in the end zone here.
Yep.
And let's see if they go to Robinson. There you see the clock, 1:16 left on it, and
in the third quarter.
It is been a nice day today. As it's starting to cool off, it's fall here. You called it. You knew the season.
Oh yeah, this feels like fall weather. Not what we've had the last week or two when it's been hot, it's been in the 80s. No, this feels like fall, just barely getting to 70. And we have a different quarterback in there right now, Quatlander.
Well, Quatlander, the ball came low. As soon as he went down and his knee hit, the play was over.
Yeah.
Dead ball, false start.
False start on guard.
On the offense. Here. It's a 5-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
That's actually a break. Because if they get to play, it's second down and 15, and with the penalty, it's first down. So they got a break on the false start.
Well, I'm sure they'll take that extra down to make it up.
54 seconds left in this. Every daughter, every father that has a daughter realizes that someday he's going to be on the sideline twisting until the cheerleading squad.
All right, they're calling another penalty too.
Well, this isn't good because you're
dead ball. False start.
Giving
on the offense. 5-yard penalty
to the Blue Jays.
Repeat. First down.
I mean, we were talking about keeping him inside their 10, but now the ball's all the way at the 38 yard line, and the Blue Jays are getting more yardage by Cougar penalties than they are their own offense.
And that's a tough spot to be in. So we will see an interesting, this is gonna be an interesting series. They're behind the eight ball now, already 1st and 20. So let's see what Garden City can do here. Hands it off, and that's Robinson. Unable to get anywhere, probably lost about two, maybe three.
Well, this started at the 20, let's call it the 28.
Yep.
And we're now sitting on the 40, and Garden City's going the wrong way.
After that big defensive stand, we're hoping a little offense, but it's still second down. We got a little bit, we got a second. It's the end of the quarter, so. Moving on, switching sides of the fields. Maybe that'll be good. Maybe the switch sides of the fields, that'll make them feel better.
Hey, now we're talking here, Evan. Sports venue, and we're talking some food here.
Oh, yeah.
And I was talking to one of their waitresses today, and she's telling me that the sandwiches are great. The cheese bread is wonderful. I know the nachos are to die for. So right on the corner of Maplewood and Middlebelt, coming down, watch the game. They have trips out of there. They're very supportive of Garden City Sports. They help You know, I haven't got any of the food for the crew meal here because of, I don't know, they just don't let me have any. But the sports venue, that's a place to be. And if you go over there, tell them you saw their commercial and what a great job we did plugging them.
Yeah, they were very good. We had their food a little while ago. They were delicious. Here's Varsity warming up, getting ready for the late game, the evening game, the night game, what have you. Prime time here in Garden City, Michigan. And going back to sports venue, they have really good pizza. I really like their pizza. And they have a sandwich there. I think it's got some man's name. It's like Mike's sandwich or Bill or something. I don't remember whose name it is, but it's a good sandwich. I get it every time I end up in there.
Well, if they really want me to come, they'll name one after Ted.
Yeah, there you go.
There's a little runner. I mean, second down, lost some more yards.
Hell, maybe if we keep talking about them so nicely, maybe they will name a sandwich after us. You
well,
know?
Go in there and say hi to Katie. She's one of the waitresses there, and tell him Ted said hi.
Yeah, there you go. Maybe I don't know what she'll do. Maybe she'll give you something free, or maybe she'll give you a kick in the pants. You know, who knows?
Katie likes me. I coached her years ago in basketball. Not a whole lot of years ago, but years ago. And Garden City's got to go forward here.
Well, that's not the way to do it.
Oh, no.
Robinson loses a few more. So be fourth down and a mile.
Well, let's put it this way. Garden City's going to hike the ball about 2.5 feet south of Warren Avenue, and they got to go to a block north of Ford for a first down. I mean, the first down marker is on the 18, and this ball is going to be snapped at the 44-yard line.
Yeah, that is a good distance for sure.
Over and under, if they punt the ball here, do they get it down to the first down marker?
I think they will.
Okay.
I think they will. I think
okay. you're an optimist.
I am an optimist. You know, I even thought the Lions were going to win today.
Oh, geez, you're brilliant. Yeah. Looks like they're going for it.
It does look like they're going for it. Huh. Little bubble screen doesn't really work out for Garden City, and they're going to turn the ball over on downs. It'll be first and 10 for the Blue Jays.
Counting the penalties, they ran six plays and they lost yardage on all six plays.
Yep. Yeah, that's not the way you want to do it, that's for sure.
This series ended up 15 yards behind where the series started. And remember, Garden City had the Blue Jays pinned down inside their own 5-yard line, and with this series of plays, Garden City has just given tremendous field. The field position has just changed tremendously, and a great break for the Blue Jays.
Yeah, this game's been kind of a war of attrition, and looks like the Blue Jays are in decent shape right now. Let's see how Garden City's defense is able to handle them.
That's a lateral.
Yep, and he's taken down, so that's lost about 2 or maybe 3. For the Blue Jays.
It's David Mested.
Yeah, he's been their big time playmaker. They've been trying to go to him all the time, very often.
Literally, there have been times where the defenses are gaining more yardage for their prospective team than the offenses.
It's a strange state of affairs we're going through right now here in Garden City.
That's the seventh play in the row that's gone backwards. I mean, it is.
Yeah, no, I believe I'm watching it just like you. It's just funny to have that happen here in a game. You know, I expect
that's a penalty.
Yeah. There's number 8. I expect in these
dead ball, false start on the offense.
Run all over
5-yard penalty.
Run everybody.
Repeat the down.
You know, one guy on each team able to outrun everybody and then be a high scoring. I didn't expect this.
Well, I think it's really hurting Garden City is not having Grant on the offensive side. And he's done a magnificent job defensively. He's number 10 out there.
Uh-huh.
I want the whole staff to know that Dan, our handheld cameraman, has moved up from the goal line all the way up to the 36-yard line.
Yeah, he's and it's not like he even has to drag his own cable either. He's got a grip there for him.
Yeah.
Here's a for a play that goes positive. Let's see who was on the tackle there.
I think
that's
a quarterback keeper.
It was. That was Bumbleuski tackled by Zemecki.
Just keeps the ball, cuts inside as Grant overruns it.
Yep.
Grant, a couple times now, and I don't know what the story is, but a couple times Grant has grabbed his hip as he hits the ground. So I don't know if he's got a hip pointer or he bruised it, but he's still out there.
He's not right now, though, actually. He's not out there right now.
Is he? Did he come off?
He came off the field, yeah. He's not on the field right now.
Well, they got a first down on that play and picked up a big chunk. Yeah, a couple times he reached down and grabbed his hip, and I don't know if he got hit there, he got bruised. Are they looking at him?
They are. I see him on the sideline right down here, just behind the cheerleaders. They are looking at him.
All right.
And so that's a big loss
because he's made, I want to say, the majority of the tackles.
And he has to have made 20 tackles so far today, maybe more. Blue Jays, this is an opportunity for them without the best defensive player for Garden City in the game.
A great play right there.
Yeah, that was Zemecki again. Looks like he's filling in. That's his second tackle on this series. So maybe he's able to step in and help out.
The ball's going to be right inside the 40, and I tell you, the field position has really turned around here in this game. Garden City knocking on the door, could not score, and then a good defensive stand as they held the Blue Jays inside the five, probably inside the two if you want to be accurate. And then they got the ball in their own 29 in great position, but a series of penalties and no advances on the play. They wound up on the 44, and now the Blue Jays are driving.
They hand it off. Up the middle side, and that's a first down and more. And that was Deedle. No, that was Alexander, excuse me, for the Blue Jays.
And you can tell right now they're missing Grant in there.
Certainly, he probably would have sniffed that out a little earlier. He's still sitting on the bench.
I think he hurt his hip. He's got a sore hip or upper leg area because he kept grabbing that. I saw him do that on two plays.
Here's Alexander again. Nope, that's Deedle, number 9. And Garden City unable to bring him down. And that's a gain of about 6 or 7. So Deedle, now.
Deedle pretending he's a pinball wizard. He's bouncing off all kinds. Watch him, how many people he bounces off here. Okay, there's a right here, contact 1, 2. He spins out of that one. Here's 3, high, hit him high. And now 3 people will bring him down here as it took a total of 6 hits to knock him down. They're running out of the pistol here. They're back under center.
Yeah. Bumbleuski.
And he's
tackled.
Smothered.
Yep. Loss of a couple.
88, 86.
I got an 83 and an 89. Williams and 83 is McNally. I don't know if you guys made these.
This is a big stance here.
Yep, this is big time. Third down and about 5. Garden City would love to stop him here.
Looks like they're going to blitz up the middle. Here it comes. It's picked up. Nice saw. Nice play. Guess who's back in?
Yep, and everybody there, everybody's hitting him on the helmet. They love it.
A delayed blitz. The middle linebacker came in trying to run the gap. Watch the middle linebacker try to run the gap, which opens up the gap between the guard and the tackle, and Grant comes blowing in there.
Yep.
Right there. Yeah, great play.
Grant, and he's able to stop number 7, Sydney Redd.
Well, whatever they did to him on the sideline, he didn't grab the leg that time.
And can of spray, magic sponge, you know, whatever it was.
Here he comes again, running. No, he shot the gap again.
he is a tackling machine out there. Look at him walk off the field. Oh yeah, there you go, big fella. There you go. All right, so that's the first down for Garden City. Big time defensive stand. Looked a little touch and go there for the Cougars for a second, but they get Grant back in the game, and he's able to make two really impressive tackles to turn the ball over on downs.
He does not hesitate. That's probably the hardest thing to do to get kids at this age is to love contact. You know, they're a little hesitant, but when you get a player like Grant, and he just shot the gap and went in and took the legs out to it. A great defensive play at high school, college, pros. That's a good play.
Oh yeah. Yeah, so all safeties like that in high school and college and yeah, in the pros. You'd love to see a guy that just loves to come up the middle and just knock the snot out of guys, you know, hit them right in the chops. All right. So that was a pitch to number two, Quatlander, and he's unable to get much. In fact, I think he lost about 4 or 5 yards.
Watch it. This is an excellent watch. Quatlander get the ball late, and then you can almost see him say, somebody in orange block here. Hey, buddies, I'm over here. They got him outside. They just had nobody in front of him to block.
I think Garden City here would like to just run the ball, run the clock. About 3 minutes to go. They're up by 6, second down. If they're able to run the clock, maybe get one first down, I think this game will be over.
Well, if they get a first down, the game will be over. They're taking what they don't want is a delay of game penalty.
Yeah.
And they're darn close to it.
Maybe they are gonna just take it. Oh, they're taking a timeout, looks like.
Well, the coach counted as much
time out
the clock as he could.
Cougars.
Yeah.
Now he'll go out, snap the ball, and they'll you know, no matter what happens on this play, they won't snap the ball till probably 140, 145 mark or somewhere around there. And here's Garden City's games. Garden City football versus, this is the games that we're televising here. Next Friday, football versus RU. And then on the 28th, you got me confused. Oh, they're scheduled. It does say scheduled here. So this weekend, you can see the Forts and.
That's midweek.
Midweek.
22nd is Tuesday.
I don't know the dates.
I'm trying to help you.
All right, and the Blue Jays and the JV are going to be next weekend. And just keep watching the Omni Edition Sports because there's football on it.
Just put it in. Just turn it on in your kitchen, on your TV, you know, wherever, and just let it go and, you know, watch it as much as
Here goes Robinson around the end.
Ooh, looks like he's got the corner.
And out of bounds. That stops the clock, though, doesn't it?
Like the clock's still rolling, so I don't know if we got a Garden City sympathizer running the clock.
No, I think, someone's called a timeout.
Now it stops.
I think the high school rules now, if you go out of bounds now in the last 4 minutes or something, the clock keeps going.
Oh, okay.
Timeout! Blue Jays!
That's a good timeout by the Blue Jays because it's third down, and if you can stop them on this play, you still want to have as much as as close to 2 minutes left to get. If the director would put that, put it back out. Now, here's the Garden City Cougars JV upcoming games. They're going to play Livonia Eagles here. Then they're going to go to Bentley and play the Orioles and the Falcons. And then the Farmington Rockets are going to come back here. And then the playoffs are the 24th and 25th. And on Halloween, they have the semifinals. And then the WLJFL Super Bowl is November 8th. And let's hope the Cougars win out the rest of their games and make the Super Bowl.
Oh, yeah. If you'd like to go watch any of those those games at Livonia. I can tell you that's Hubbard and 5 Mile in between Farmington Road and Merriman Road. Not too far.
Now, if they call another timeout, put the other schedule up, and I'll try to do better. Hey, look at this great run.
Just short of a first down, but that makes it 4th and 1. And an interesting decision here for Garden City. Calling a time. Well, the clock is stopped right now.
Yeah, Quatlander trying to get the kink out of his back.
They're calling it a first down.
Are they? Well, that he fought. That is a huge.
Yep.
That's a huge play because now they got 4 downs and a 1:56 on the clock.
And the Blue Jays only have 1 timeout left.
Well, so if they take it, I hope Christian gives me an opportunity to make up for the way I really screwed up that TV schedule.
Well, I think this is pretty much over. I don't think they can stop the clock enough to, unless Garden City makes a mistake here, and that's a big-time pitch there by
Quatlander running tough. For a little kid, he's running tough here.
Russell making the pitch to Quatlander, yeah. So, looks like they have called the timeout.
Timeout
here.
Blue Jays.
I imagine they'll just take, once the clock starts, they'll just take a knee.
Yep, that I think would be the way to go. Minute 22, you really can run it all the way down almost to about 2 seconds. So,
they're not going to give me a second chance on that schedule.
Okay, we're going to thank the crew here.
There you see Dan York right in the middle of the screen there.
And the young man in the hat next to him, that is Brandon George. And that's Brett George's son, one of our helpers. Oh, here we go. We got, nice pull here.
Oh, look at that. I don't think I have that.
There's Brandon George, and that's a very awkward smile.
He's better looking than his dad.
Yeah,
he is.
That's true.
That's true. Thank God for Mom. Anybody else that we want to mention?
Yeah, well, we'll thank Jason Merrill up on the
lift. We got Jason already. We got him some airtime.
Jake Mahan up top.
Oh, yay, way to go. Wave, Jake. Wave.
There you go.
If we don't like his shot, we just throw him over the back. So yeah. He's been doing okay.
Or we can, the ladder's right here. We could just pick up the ladder and lock him up there. We don't even have to. He'll just be stuck up there for a while until he climbs down.
And this could be the last. Russell he's still fighting, and I guess a flock of Blue Jays.
And
I don't know.
Number 40 there is signaling Noah Poison.
There's Jace.
Yep, Jason up in the lift there.
That's Jason as close Merrill. To heaven as Jason is ever going to get.
Okay, he's blowing kisses or something. Get off that shot. He's blowing kisses. We don't need to see that.
He's our resident model.
That is true. He did model for us earlier today. So, and thank you to all the guys in the truck. Zach King. Noah Pickett as well in the truck.
Yeah. Last night or the other night, we were calling by his French name, Peugeot.
Oh, yeah. And here goes Russell.
Here goes Russell. Russell can make this exciting. One man to beat. He gets rudely knocked out.
And also Christian Gibbons, of course, here in the booth directing the show, running all the stuff here. Garden City's really jacked up about this one.
Well, Garden City, we didn't even mention it. Yeah, they were 0-3 coming in here. And they've done a wonderful job. And you know what? They won this defensively.
Yep.
I mean, they play tough. And once again, I mean, we would call it Grant's number all night long.
Yeah.
But he wasn't the only one.
No.
Literally, they were outplaying the offensive line, and great defense by the Orange and Blue.
And of course, I'd like to point out that Zemecki also made a fair few tackles.
Yeah.
Robinson, we saw on defense, get a few good plays. There were guys all over the place that were making big plays. It's not just any single one of them. This is a team game for a reason, right?
Well, these young men started practicing the last day of July.
Yeah.
Think back how long ago that was. And today is the first time they've tasted victory. So this has got to be sweet. We didn't talk about them, but the cheerleaders did a great job. But the coaching staff did a great job, especially at the end of the first half. And these young men I mean, this is day in and day out, 5 days a week playing. You know, and now they're going to school, so it's a tough road for these young guys, and they play a lot hard. This yep. has got to be a sweet afternoon.
Yep, and I got to thank Colton Henderson, too. We missed him when we were thanking all the crew. This has been a whole lot of fun watching Garden City get a win here. We'll be back for the second game in just a little while. This has been a presentation of Omni Edition Television.